So this moment, saints, is to give opportunity to the Lord Jesus to re-enlighten the fire of love and of the gospel in each one of us. For this purpose, the brothers who are here today with us, they came to share their experiences of the gospel. Are you ready? Are you ready? Very good. So the brothers who are here to share with us, we have Amir Silva. André Dong. And Joãozinho.
Só para ter certeza. E o Joelzinho?
Joelzinho.
Nesse primeiro momento,
so in this first moment in our living room, I'd like Amir to share with us a few words so we can open up our hearts.
Amém.
Amen.
Jesus é o Senhor.
Jesus is Lord.
Então, como André Oliveira falou,
so just like André Oliveira said, is going to lead us, ask questions, and the intention is to show that we are all equal. We all have difficulties. However, we all need advance. Amen? So the burden of this conference in the past few years as well that Brother Dong has shared with us is that we need to grow in life, to grow in the life of God. We are His children. And some of us are at the stage of spiritual stage of teenagers, and we cried out, Abba Father, but we need to grow. We need to become heirs of God. Mature children that God can count on at any time, any place. Therefore, to this purpose, we come to the conferences, we hear God's word, and until now, all we've heard gave us a great basis of the importance for us to draw away from the things of the world and draw near of God's things. So last night, Brother Ezra, he showed us a word that it scares us, but also gives us the reality. It's the reality we have. And also he talked about bacteria and viruses. And I was paying very attention to it. I don't have experience at this subject. However, concerning God's life, I know something. God's life can also be can only be propagated in a high temperature. So that's why Brother Ezra showed us that we need to be fervent in spirit. We need to be burning. So what I want to show you today, young ones, is that we can increase our temperature in spirit. Amen. So I'd like to show you that it's very important to increase the temperature of our spirit. And also, I want to show you that you can do this easily. To come to this conference, brothers and sisters, it's very good, right? We're going to go out burning in spirit. And when we go back, you're going to keep burning. This is our great challenge. Because only when we are burning in spirit, we can spread God's word, God's life. So we have a few verses in the Bible that tells us about this. And I'd like you to open your Bibles in Thessalonians. 1 Thessalonians.
Capítulo 5, versículo 19.
Chapter 5, verse 19.
Você vai falar ele olhando para o irmão do lado, tá bom? Pode falar. Vamos lá, de novo agora.
Do not quench the spirit.
Vamos lá, lendo e orando, não apagueis.
So let's pray, read. Do not quench.
Não apagueis o espírito.
Do not quench the spirit.
Então, o espírito aqui.
Therefore, the spirit here.
É como fogo.
It's very clear to us, like fire. It can be quenched, and we know this, right?
Nós temos essa experiência.
We have had this experience before, but what we need to do is to use our spirit, calling upon the name of the Lord. So 1 Corinthians chapter 12, Brother Andra shared with us in the first message about spiritual gifts. We all saints at this stage of spiritual life, we have received God's life. Amen? We've all called upon the Lord's name, and His life is in us. And now God's life has to be maintained in a certain temperature. And together with God's life comes gifts. We have received God's grace. God's grace is God Himself given to us freely. The brothers shared with us in previous messages, but I want to show you that this grace, if you do not keep a certain temperature in your spirit, if your spirit is not burning, it's going to be vain. God's grace that was given to us, that is Jesus Himself, it needs to be exercised. Paul told Timothy that you need to burn the fire of God's gift that is in you. The Spirit is like the fire we've seen here in the opening of the conference. There was an image, and as I lived in farms and in the countryside, we depended on the fire. Sometimes you need to blow. Or even get a paper and try to bring light to the fire. So many of us, we are like, here, we need the Lord to blow in us. So every blow is just going to re-enlighten our fire. But in some ways, we even use fans. So the Spirit is like fire. And you need to keep feeding the fire. And we have received God's life, God's grace, and now we need to use gifts that we have received, because God's grace can become vain. I'd like you to see this and read a verse with me. 2 Corinthians chapter 6.
Capítulo 6, versículo 1.
Verse 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 1.
Vamos pedir primeiro os irmãos lerem.
So first, brothers, they read it.
E nós,
we then, as workers together with Him, also plead with you not to receive the grace of God in vain. So now the sisters, we then, as workers together with him, also plead with you not to receive the grace of God in vain. So I want to show you how important is God's grace and how it is related to our gifts. So we need to use our gifts in the church life. So why in every message and every meeting the brothers talk about the importance of the church life or the activities that are promoted? It's because we need to use our gifts. We need to gain more grace from God. So this keeps our temperature maintained, to be maintained. God, Paul told us to not receive the grace of God in vain. So how can we receive in vain? Well, just do nothing. And he has another verse, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 10. We can read all together. 1 Corinthians 15:10. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me. So see, by God's grace, all of us, by God's grace, we are what we are. And his grace that was toward us was not vain. But he says, but I called his name. I served at Buca Fair. I went to the meetings. Amen? I labored. So how God's grace cannot become vain? It's by working, it's by laboring, it's doing something. You, for example, what Satan does not want is for you to find out that within you there is the spirit of power. He doesn't want you to find this, find out about this. Because the spirit within us, Satan is afraid of him, of it. Because the person, when it's in spirit, has the power to overcome all barriers. And not only in negative ways, you know, to not go to the world, as we have seen in this conference, but it is for you to invade Satan's kingdom, preaching the gospel. So Satan does not want you to find out that within you there is a spirit, a powerful spirit. And I really like a passage in the Bible that talks about a pool that an angel came and touched the pool every once a year. So every man who was near the pool threw himself in the pool and he was healed. So I've always imagined the other ones who were there trying to be healed, because many were there. And once a year, an angel touched the pool and was healed. So good news is, this water that heals, this spirit is within us now. And I really like you to realize that this is within you. So every place you are, you can touch this water. So when we say, oh Lord Jesus, you're touching this water. At any place, when you're alone, and also I shared with you and I testified that I used to have many difficulties. When I was Catholic, the priest, he told me that I didn't deserve to gain the bread, so I went away. So when I came to the conferences, I'm going to say it. And I saw many Chinese people, and I told Brother Marcelino, oh, all these Chinese people want our money. And then my brother told me, repent, because you don't know what you're saying. And what money? We have nothing. Because I used to come and only Chinese people talked, they spoke. And a translator, it was a Chinese translator, and I didn't understand anything. So I came here because of the girls, so many beautiful girls. Even now, there are more beautiful girls than before. When I came here, I was 20 years old. I looked at one and looked at another one. But I really didn't understand anything that the brothers shared. And I was very helped by a brother. Once I went in the middle of the woods, and he told me, oh, you need to understand something now. I came from the countryside, and he told me, oh, just shout, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus. And he told me, you have a hard soul, you need to be broken, you need to release your spirit. So I started shouting, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, and he told me how to pray the gospel to a cow, and I told the cow, oh, cow, you don't have the spirit, but I do. So if you don't have a farm, just do this in the bathroom, any place is good. We do. So within you, there is a spirit. And you need to touch the spirit at any time. Do not quench the spirit. Do not be lukewarm. This is very dangerous. I am a client of Ipiranga. It's to get oil. So when I got there, we were calling upon the name of the Lord, but we started to call more because we didn't have oil. We didn't have anything. And we were on the road, we were driving. So we were very worried. Oh, Lord Jesus. So when I saw Ipiranga, I started shouting, oh, Lord Jesus. Don't do this with your spiritual life. Don't do this. Amen? Let's always keep burning in the spirit. Because we need this in our lives. So we need to keep burning in spirit, calling upon the Lord's name. So there are many ways to cause this. And I have a personal experience with this. So who he studies, works, so he works, raise your hands. Oh, wow. So raise your hands again, please. Oh, what a blessing. I'm not going to ask for offerings. Not now, at least.
So when I learned this lesson, I thought, oh, I really need to be in spirit all the time.
So right when I was converted, I had an automobile shop, and I said, oh, I don't need to wait for anything, I can cause a situation. I've always worked with automobiles, and I always worked with wood. So I set a target in my heart. Whoever comes here to talk about business, I'm going to preach the gospel to him. And suddenly, a guy offered me a paint with saints in it, and he wanted to sell me this. And I told him, oh, you read the Bible? And he said, yes, I do. So I told him, so get your Bible, and let's talk a bit about the Bible. So he said, oh, I know this. So I told him, so you need to call upon the name of the Lord. And he called upon the name of the Lord. So I said, now you're ready to be baptized. And he said to me, I want to be baptized. So I called my mother. I called her. I went to my house. I closed the shop and we baptized him. And saints, he's firm the church life until today. He was known here in the countryside of São Paulo. He used to drive the Expo Book bus, and all his family believed in the Lord. So the Lord blessed me, and I opened another shop. So this experience is, I had a mattress shop, and right in the corner, it opened a shop with that sells products for animals. So he invited me to play. He invited me to play with him, and I told him, oh, but to play, you need to call upon the name of the Lord first. And he called it, and then we started to play. And every time he opened his shop, he said, oh, Lord Jesus, let's play.
Esse irmão é o irmão Marquinhos Mialik de Colina, né, que serve no que ajuda no CEAP e tudo.
So,
eu acho que ele não tá aqui, né?
I don't know if this brother is here. He didn't come.
Irmãos, onde nós estamos,
but wherever we are, we can practice this. We can say, well, for example,
como é que você veio para a reunião hoje?
How did you come to the meeting today? You, sister, what's your name?
Você.
Yes, you.
Vitória.
Vitória.
Vitória. Hallelujah.
Vitória, hallelujah.
Você veio desesperada para a reunião hoje?
Did you come desperate to the meeting today? Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus. What am I going to do? Did you come like this? No, I don't think so, right? Oh, so. Okay, let's ask the brothers. You, brother. What's your name?
Guilherme.
So, did you come like this to the meeting? Oh, really? Okay. In this case, you should say no. Okay. So, who came desperate? Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus. Today, how is this meeting going to be? Raise your hand. So, just a few, right? But praise the Lord. What I want to say is this. I knew I had to say something today, so I didn't get enough sleep last night. Because I always get enough sleep. I woke up very early. I got my Bible and I called upon the name of the Lord. Lord Jesus, oh Lord Jesus. To know the difference here, I had a commitment here to share with you. So why aren't we always desperate? Because we don't have commitment. So you need to cause a commitment in your life. Lord, today I want to give a Tree of Life newspaper. I want to preach the gospel today in my school. I want to serve at Book Cafe today. At the end, tell the Lord, I want to go to the GPP. And if you can't go to the GPP, or many of you work, preach the gospel at your work. But Jesus, today I'm going to preach the gospel at my work, at my job. So there's going to be an inner battle that is going to say no to you, but then things are going to heat up. So the burden is we need to heat up, we need to increase temperature. And we can cause this burning fire because the Spirit is in us. Okay, so thank you for sharing this. So we have a few questions already, and one is for Brother André Dong.
André Dong. Tudo que parecer irmão André aqui é você hoje, tá? É jovem que nasceu no lar cristão.
So, he's a young one who was born in a Christian family, and he'd like to know about the experience with the father, how he helped you to keep your spirit burning. That's true. I can say that everything I learned I own a lot to my father. So my father used to go, he always supported me, and to get also my brothers, we always served the Lord. We were always in the Lord's way. And the same disease I had, Joel also had. And I got it when I was 6 years old. It's a virus. And after a while, it went away, but it gave me consequences. Some parts of my body did not function well, but my parents, they were very wise. I am the fifth son, so I got this disease in Taiwan, and I was the poor baby of the family. And I could have grown up very spoiled, and my parents, they treated me like just they treat my other brothers. They didn't spoil me. And my mother once told me, oh, we do not think you're a poor baby. Because if you see yourself as a poor baby, you're going to be useless. So I experienced many things. I went through many sufferings. But I believed in the Lord very early. And just like Amir shared about grace. Yes, that's true. Without God's grace, I am nothing. The Lord does all things in our lives. He operates miracles in our lives, and we depend on Him. So after this, my father, after I went through the stage of childhood and also being a teenager, my father, he taught me many things, and he treated with my character. And I don't complain. Today, I can stand up, I can serve the Lord, because my father helped me a lot. If he saw me and treated me as a poor baby, I don't know where I was going to be today. So I am here before you, and my father, he has a special role in my life. I told you already about my conversion, what my father means. He was always praying, and I thought, oh, this God, I need to get to know this God better, the God of my father. Hallelujah. So I was captured by God. His love was bigger than my resistance. So God has governed my entire life. Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God, but not me, God's grace in me. Amen? And also concerning the Spirit, since we need to have a burning spirit, the Lord doesn't want us to be lukewarm, not even bacteria, they want lukewarm. Viruses, they don't like lukewarm. That's right. I'm sorry, they do like lukewarmness, so we need to cure everything with fire. Amen? Oh, Lord Jesus! Oh, Lord Jesus! Amen. So, Joel, so concerning the gospel, that you dedicated your entire life to it, have you never failed? Oh, well. So I believed in the Lord when I was 17 years old. In 1975, in July, and right after it, I started a meeting. And I remember now, I used to travel with Pedro Dong in a van to Vale do Paraíba.
culpa é minha.
And Pedro has a few white hair because of me.
E logo tive sentimento de servir ao Senhor.
And I got a feeling to serve the Lord, but when I looked at me, I thought, how am I going to serve? I had a feeling.
Logo vim para a vida da igreja, né?
When I came to the church life,
eu quero
I said, I want to serve. And I looked at Miguel, Pedro, all the responsible ones, and I said, oh, wow, Jesus, I want to serve with them one day. And then Brother Tong, he told us about preaching the gospel, and I said, Lord, I want this. Brother Tong, he said, oh, for you to go out and preach, you need to be married. And I said, oh, no. And then, I used to look at so many sisters, and I thought they were so pretty. I still do.
Hoje à noite, lá no Rosa de Saron, os de 25 anos...
And tonight, Sharon's Rose, I'm going to share with you my story. So you're both 25 years old. Go to Sharon's Rose, and I want to encourage you. It's possible to get married. And Andrea, he got married. And he encouraged me. Encouraged me as well. And then I said, Lord, Andrea got married. Lord, I want to serve you. I need a wife. And one day, a sister called Maria went to Guarulhos. And I came from Brasília, and the brothers from Brasília told me, Brother Joel, you need to take care of a sister who's coming. And I said, oh no, who is it? Oh God. So I went to the airport and I met Sister Maria. I looked at her and she looked at me and she said, good morning, are you Brother Joel? And I said, oh, it's me. And then, when I was 19, I started to serve. So at that time, I was about 26 years old, almost 27. So what happened? I took care of her, I took her places, and one day she told me, oh, Joel, are you going to the meeting? And I said, yes. So she told me, oh, I made a chocolate cake for you. And then at the end, we got married. I got married in Guarulhos, São Paulo.
Não, lá perto da Ana Rosa, no metrô ali. Praça da Árvore, na Praça da Árvore. Na Praça da Árvore, sim. Aí, minha lua de mel...
And my honeymoon was at Poços de Caldas, where Ulysses...
Foi meu cicerone.
He took care of me.
Marco Melo era o gerente do hotel.
Marco Melo also.
São tantas histórias, ó Jesus.
So many stories, oh Lord Jesus. Okay, so the difficulties of the gospel. We also have difficulties at marriage. But so, okay, I went to Ceará in the northeast of Brazil. And when I got there, I was like, oh, I'm an excellent technician. And I like my job, I like electronics. And... And for you, the most beautiful thing in here is the great screen. However, what I like most is all the electronics behind the screen. I used to like electronic a lot. So when I got to Ceará, oh, I'm going to be great. I have a great job. I'm going to serve the Lord. And I already had a child, 9 months old, Felipe. So the first month I lived there, I was unemployed. The second month as well. Third month, unemployed. And then I told my wife, oh, how is it? And she said, oh, we have nothing else. We have nothing to eat. I only have Felipe's milk because I am his milk. She was still breastfeeding. She breastfed him until 4 years old. He was 4 years old. So what happened? Oh, okay, I'm going to look for a job. I'm going to try everything. And I had that feeling, oh, Lord, I have a wife, I have a child. Oh, I drank a coffee because I had nothing to eat. And then I went look for a job. 1 hour, 2 hours, and then I was so hungry. I sat down in the street, and then I said, Lord, what happened? Lord, you abandoned me. What now? I'm your servant. What happened? And at that time, the Lord said, I didn't abandon you. You abandoned me. Without you, you're nothing. You can do nothing. And from that day on, my life changed. It was a defeat that led me to victory. So just like Brother Dong, he took care of André. And when he had to deal with André, he dealt with him. And I have a name tag that says Joel Dong. It's there in my wall. I am what I am because of God's grace and because of Brother Dong. He perfected me. I have a lot to do. But he told me, if you want to serve the Lord, do not be afraid. Who is afraid cannot serve. So do not be afraid to serve the Lord.
De ouro ainda é gaiola. Feliz é o passarinho que sai da sua gaiola e sai para servir ao Senhor.
Happy is the bird that goes out to preach the gospel. Not ears heard or eyes have seen, while God has prepared to the ones who love Him. And to serve the Lord is to love. There are defeats in the way, but it's worth it. So I have a question for Brother André Dong, but you also can help him. Our brother asked, in difficulties, have you never thought about giving up? When you were desperate, what happened? Oh, I wanted to give up. And then go away. Many times I thought about doing this, I couldn't handle anymore. I felt that I couldn't go on like this. But we always call upon the Lord's name, oh Lord Jesus. It's a very difficult phase, and we think we're never going to overcome this barrier. We want to give up, and we decide, oh, I'm just going to leave everything, give up, and go. I can't handle anymore. It's enough. But then God's voice in our inner being is not a storm, like, oh. But deep within, there is a voice telling us, oh, Lord Jesus, keep going. Keep going. I am with you. So that situation, that voice, it causes us to keep going. Our strength comes, and we don't know where it comes from, but we know that we are raised again, and full of burden, full of happiness, to serve the Lord, full of gratitude in our hearts to have this opportunity to serve the saints and serve the Lord.
Amir, tem uma boa para você. Eu queria até contar uma situação minha de grande desânimo.
And Amir said he also wants to share a situation. I think all of you know this story. First, the person who preached the gospel to me, he wasn't very wise. So, for example, if we were gathered in 4 or 5 people, he constantly did this to me, so don't do this to anyone. He used to tell me, oh, I'm sorry, Amir, you're not mature enough to hear this. Just go away. And he did this to me many times, so after it, I understood he had to do that to me, so I wouldn't give up. Because this was very humiliating. So one thing that happened to me, I went to Foz do Iguaçu in 1990. So 2 years after I got married, I saw that João André got married. So I said, oh, I can get married again. I can also get married. So I'm also going to share my story tonight. But then, I lived for 1 year and 6 months at Foz do Iguaçu, but I didn't know everyone. Me and my wife, we went out to preach the gospel. We had a baby car full of books. And then we got out to Christian groups and preached. We did this for more than 1.5 years. So there was a Chinese brother there. He called Brother Dong and he said, oh, Brother Dong, I think it's better for Brother Ami to go out because we have nothing here. He's dead. Brother Dong, he was very wise, and he said, oh, is he dead? Well, let him die because after death we have resurrection. And then I came to knowledge that this brother called Brother Dong. He wanted me to go away, and I was very dismayed. I think Brother Dong, he doesn't remember this, but I called him. And also said, oh, Peter, a brother, he had invited me to go to a city from another state to serve there. So Peter said, but there's no one there. And I said, oh, there are many people here. I preached, I sold books. And he said, oh, don't be dismayed. Be firm in the Lord, wait in the Lord. And this just gave me a burden again. So to have fellowship with the brothers, these give us burden. Do not keep anything to yourself. Have fellowship with the saints. So I have a feeling, failure. Why are we not even proud anymore? Because if we look back, there's only failures. Failures are important because when we go out and when we serve the Lord, do not be afraid to make mistakes. You need to be afraid to not want to stand up again. So our lives have many difficulties, have many failures. Okay, very good. So there is a young one who asks, maybe sometimes we look at you and we say, oh, these guys, they don't have difficulties to preach the gospel. And he said that when he preached the gospel, daily, he has difficulty to approach people. He thinks he's going to disturb them. And are you not shy to preach the gospel? So, Joel, when you said that when you have difficulties and you need help to walk. I thought that people used to think, oh, here comes the guy with difficulties, and every time I knocked at someone's door, the person said, oh, I'm sorry, son, I have nothing today to give to you. And, oh, God, the person thinks I want money. And then the person said, oh, I'm sorry, son, just come back later, I have nothing. And I was like, oh, Jesus, what am I going to do now? So I went with the Sister Maria, and I told her, Sister Maria, I'm going to preach the gospel. And then she said, oh, I'm shy, I can't. And I told her, no, we're going together. You knock at the door, the person comes, and I preach the gospel. Okay, let's go. And she was like, oh, good morning, please. And then the person came, and she was like, I'm sorry. And then I was like, oh, hello, my name is Joel. How are you? It's a pleasure. And when I said good morning, okay, everything was fine. So we're always going to have difficulties. Because the enemy doesn't want you to preach God's word. But as I would say, you need to overcome small things first. Small with a leaflet, start with a leaflet, start saying something. Because to preach the gospel is a matter of love. And there's no one who can resist or hide from a loving heart. The face of someone who loves you shine. And when you talk about God's love, you're talking about something real, true. So I'm going to share a story. I had an old van, and I to the authorities, and then a woman who was going to talk to me, she had gel in her hair, it was all tied up, and she had a white dress with black dots in it. And she had lipstick on, earrings. But this old lady was so cute. So a person went next to her and told her, oh, Maria, you look so pretty today. What happened? And she said, oh, John, I'm in love. At that time, the Lord, He showed Himself to me. When you love the Lord, people see God's love in your face. Sometimes you don't even need to do anything. The person looked at you and he says, oh, you have something different. There's something different about you. Well, it's love.
Eu sempre tive muita dificuldade para sair.
Well, I've always had difficulties to go out and preach, and until today, it gets me stomachache. But I'm always hungry. So I don't have any difficulties that cause me to lose my hunger. Every time we talk about going out, I have a lot of difficulties. And sometimes I'm so scared that I say, okay, let's go out. And I say, oh, I need to go out together with them. I can't just send people. So I get headache, stomachache. You have inner conflicts. Oh, who's going to come? How's it going to be? You don't know if an alien is going to open the door or not. So I had difficulties, yes. I want to share a story now that happened at Sumaré. When we used to go out to preach, brothers, they used to hand out to us books from the Ministry of Human Life. So you opened the first page, we have a lesson, and then the next page, we had another lesson about the fall, and then a third page, another lesson, and then God entering man's spirit. So we had to go out and preach. We had many fears, difficulties. But I thought, I'm always going to obey because this is going to save me. If they tell me to go, I go. This helped me a lot. So I went out, and the first house that we knocked on, me and two sisters, there was no gate. but there was a window glass door, and the person opened the door, and he said, "Oh, how can I help you?" And I told him, "I want to say something to you. The man was created in the image of God, then he sinned, then blah, 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 blah." And he was like, "Oh, this is so boring." And I told him, "Oh, yeah, you're right. This is boring." And he told me, "You need to be more spontaneous." And I told him, "Jesus loves you." Yes, yes. Now he told me, "Now go to the next house and do it properly." And he closed the door in my face. He shut the door. So his reply was, "Go to the next house and do it properly." So also when I went out to preach in São Carlos, me and two sisters, I was so afraid, I was so embarrassed. But those two sisters, oh God, they were filled with the Spirit. And we went to a house, and an elder, he shouted, "Oh, what is it? Oh, we want to talk to you." "No, no, no, you're not going to come in." "Oh no, but we wanted to talk about Jesus." "Oh no, I don't want to listen to it." And one of the sisters, she told him, "Oh, please, come closer." And he was like, "No, no." And she was, "Please, please." And then we started jumping and singing a hymn. And this man, he started laughing. Well, I'm telling you this because if it was for me, he was going to hell. But praise the Lord, there was someone in spirit there. And then we started singing, and this man started smiling. And one of the sisters, she asked, "Please let us go in. We want to take this joy to you." He had a woman inside his house that was totally paralyzed. And he was desperate, so we prayed with him, he was saved. He and his wife were baptized. It was a wonderful experience. Praise the Lord for these two sisters that were with me. So there's an interesting question here. So you abandoned everything to serve the Lord, right? And sometimes you leave your families and go to other countries. So, how did this happen? How were you touched? Oh, Lord Jesus. Look, we serve the Lord gladly. And for us to serve the Lord is in first place, is the priority in our lives. There's a lot to do in our jobs, but we serve the Lord gladly. And I remember that very early, I went to university, I started studying, but then I started traveling with Brother Don, translate for him. And I know that before, Miguel used to translate. He was always available. But then Miguel, he couldn't travel a lot anymore. And I was not very prepared to translate because I never studied Chinese. When I left Taiwan, I never studied there. So I never studied Chinese. For me to translate Chinese to Portuguese, it was something very hard to do. And I was so afraid. So, for example, for me to go up the stage and talk with the crowd and translating, I was shake all the time. But once, if it doesn't work out, do not give up. The Lord is going to perfect you. And praise the Lord. Because of this opportunity, I've learned. Well, okay, so I've learned it. I speak more or less Portuguese. We speak more or less Spanish. more or less of English and more or less of Chinese. If I didn't have this opportunity, I would never learn so many languages. So praise the Lord. Seek first kingdom and His righteousness. And everything, all things will be added to you. And also I want to share something. At that time, we didn't have translators, but today, praise the Lord, we have Peter, we have Ezra. Ezra used to live in the U.S., and also Solomon. So it was only me and Miguel translating him. Praise the Lord. I could travel a lot and preach the gospel with Brother Dong in conferences. And my wife, once she was waiting for me, and she was pregnant with my second daughter, Caris Dong. And I had to go to Venezuela. And we had a 15 days trip. So we could take advantage of the ticket because it was too expensive. So in this specific trip, I stayed 30 days away, Colombia and in Venezuela. And when my wife was pregnant, the doctor said that Maria need to be totally resting. And we already had a son, Timóteo. So how could I leave her alone? She had to take care of Timóteo. And I had to travel. So I said, Lord, I don't think this is going to work out. I'm going to tell Brother Dong that it's not going to work out. Because I have a family. My wife is pregnant. So brothers, the more negative I was, the Lord came with me with words, and He showed me that that the tribes of Israel, He preferred to be on this side of the river, and they did not cross the river. And He asked Joshua to be in that side of the river, the two tribes and a half. So Joshua, he said, but by love of the other tribes, you need to all go. You need to battle with him, fight with them. So when your brothers conquer the land, then you can come back. So they went. They were one, and they went to conquer the land with their brothers, the nine tribes and a half. And when they went, they left cattle, children, families. So how is this possible? God took care of them. So based on this passage, Maria is going to have a C-section, and I was very worried. So how am I going to do this? Oh, Maria's going to have my baby, so we were planning everything. And when I got home, I went to the bedroom, and the first thing I saw, she was lying down. And, oh, how are you? How are things? So I didn't know anything. And she was laughing, ha, ha, ha. And she didn't say anything. And then, oh, where is the belly? Is it gone? And she said, oh, look, well, it's behind you. There was a basket. And when I looked, the girl was in it. Oh, wow. So don't be afraid when you're traveling. Because of the Lord, if I stay there, I would have taken care of her, but God took better care of her. So just go that God, He will take care of your house and your businesses. Jesus is Lord. So we're almost in the end. But I also would like to say that The question was about abandoning everything. And what is the secret? Well, the secret is that my wife always tells me, oh, go to work. But the secret is to choose someone that loves the Lord and that everything is going to work out. My wife tells me, oh, you're not a crippled, so go work, do something. My wife says, go, boy. Do not be lazy. Go away. Go travel. Oh, so much love. So our last question is, so how can we preach the gospel, the ones who work and study, they cannot travel? So what are your experiences in this subject? So first, I used to work for André. He was my boss. At Fonte da Vida. It was only me. I was my boss because there was no one else working for him. So I worked with André. The Lord blessed me a lot. I had an interview at Taltechi, a company. So I worked there. There was an assembly line, and even so at lunchtime, we had a small break. Between the time of lunch and the time you got out of work. So at lunchtime, I gathered some people I knew and some brothers, and we sang, we talked about football, our daily living, and then we also preached the gospel. And also at the break, after breakfast. So when you want something, you need to want, you need to have this desire in your heart. So the Lord, we're going to give you opportunities. Even that person that makes fun of you. One day someone came. He had a problem, and he remembered of me. So I went there, I preached the gospel to him, and he received the Lord as his Savior. So do not be afraid at your job, at your university. It's possible to preach the gospel. I've experienced this in my life. Okay, it's possible to preach the gospel at your job, right? I mean, so yeah, it's possible. We always need to have leaflets, the daily food with us. So my experience is I don't work in the world anymore, but I work at a GPP book cafe. So now we have the idea to open a book cafe at a shopping center. And people, they come to us, engineering, architects, and I've preached the gospel to 8 engineers. And one architect has been saved, and he's calling upon the name of the Lord. He's from Ribeirão Preto, and I talked to him today. So every day he sends me a text, and he says, are you okay, brother Ami? Oh, Lord Jesus. So wherever we are, we can preach the gospel. Even though we have difficulties to say things, we have the words which are precious too. So concerning the preaching of the gospel, the Lord gives us many opportunities. When I traveled to São Tomé Príncipe, I couldn't carry my luggage and go up the stairs. And then a boy came and helped me. And then I thanked him and I started to preach the gospel to him. And then we sat on the plane, and I found out he was one of the ministers of the São Tomé Príncipe. So use what you have. I used my polio, my disease. So someone came to him, to me once, and he just said, oh, what do you have? And then I said, I have the virus OE. And I said, oh, this is very terrible. It works in your inner being, it changes all your structures, and it changes your family. And she was like, oh my God, really? And then I preached the gospel to this person, and she and then she became to carry this virus that it was actually the Lord Jesus he was talking about. So do we have announcements?
O que segue agora na nossa sala são as oportunidades. E a gente gostaria de falar com vocês.
So now we want to talk to you about the importance of GPP, okay?
Você fica aqui? Cadê o amém? Amir.
Amém.
Amen.
Primeiro,
first of all,
pessoalmente tenho sempre quando falo do CEAP,
when I talk about GPP,
ninguém que não pode ir pro CEAP se sentir condenado.
I ask you who cannot go to GPP to not feel condemned, because GPP is an opportunity that the Lord gives us. And maybe you have no conditions to go because of work or because of study, but you can pray for GPP, you can offer to GPP, and you can be a GPP wherever you are. Because the spirit of a GPP is exactly what we're saying. Someone who's always calling upon the name of the Lord, someone who knows it's useful to the Lord, who has been called by the Lord. So we would like also that everyone in his own time to give the Lord at least 6 months or even 1 year to serve the Lord. Amen? So nowadays you can be sent to Africa, amen? So Miguel is going to talk about Africa, and you can serve in Europe. Amen. You can serve a GPP or even study there. You can go to the US, to Mexico. And you also can go to GPP anywhere in Brazil and South America. Amen. You can be perfected for a while. Keep the spirit burning. So your appreciation for the Lord and the gospel, you need to set a time for you to be useful in the Lord's hands. Amen? So I want you to raise your hands who already went to the GPP.
Muito bem. Desses que já fizeram, quem sente que tem que fazer de novo?
So the ones who went to GPP, who he fears that need to go again.
Temos 250 inscritos, mais ou menos.
Okay, we already have 250 to go to the GPP. So who's never been to the GPP?
Quem ainda não foi, dá uma balança.
Raise your hands.
Diga assim, eu vou.
And say, I'll go.
Vocês são muito obedientes, viu,
irmão? Oh, you're so obedient. Praise the Lord. So the important thing is to dedicate our time to the Lord. So the saints are going to share a bit.
E vamos ter uma breve comunhão assim no final dessa reunião. Então, por favor, aguente mais um pouquinho. Ninguém aqui está com mais fome do que eu. Tá bom? Vai lá.
Amém. Só continuando o que o Amir está falando, né?
Amen. So, just
muito do exemplo da farinha que o Ezra deu ontem.
I really liked the example of the flour that Ezra told us last night. Do you remember?
Deu o exemplo da farinha ontem, né?
You remember, right? You gave the example of the flour, right?
Ah,
no. Oh, no. It's about Fahrenheit. I did not know this word.
Fahrenheit.
Oh, Fahrenheit. Okay, Ezra, thank you. Lord Jesus, forgive me. I'm trying to learn English. Do you know Duolingo? It's free, right?
Senhor Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Mas de qualquer maneira, irmãos, a questão
anyhow, Ezra shared last night, it's very important we need to have an example, a model, a role model, and we need to understand and need to go to PP to be perfected and useful to in the Lord's hands. It needs to burn in our hearts. I lost almost 20 pounds, and it was very hard for me to lose it. So now it's very hard to maintain my weight. It's very hard. I think it's even harder to lose than to lose. So we're here in the conference, we're being led to the Spirit, and when we go back to our homes, we need to keep burning. It's not easy. So we really want to encourage you to go to GPP, amen? So concerning the GPP in North America, we began this almost 4 years ago. Ago we had a calling to preach the gospel there in North America. The gospel of grace was preached there in an intense way, but we still need to preach the kingdom, the gospel of kingdom. So we still lack this gospel. So praise the Lord, many young people who are here, couples, they answer this calling, and today is a reality there, but the Lord wants to keep advancing. So we rented a house in Los Angeles. So the ones who want to work in Hollywood, who always dreamed about working in Hollywood, here is your opportunity. You can take a picture at the mountain and with Jesus. So now we have GPP in Los Angeles, we have the world, the west side, but now we have a mission trip to California. In 10 days, we sold 1,300 books there, and we testified that a brother there was very encouraged because the region was very open to the gospel and also to the books. So Brother Dong, he encouraged us to have a mission trip there, so we count on you for this. And then in December, many young people sought us because we don't study and work in December, January, February. So young people, they stay here, they go to the beach. So we're going to have a holiday in Los Angeles at GPP, at a co-porter's house we rented. So if you decide to go to GPP there, you want to have fellowship with you, and if you have a burden and you can't go to GPP now, we had fellowship with saints that already served in the U.S., and we're going to have lunch today, okay? Amen? You're going to have lunch today to have fellowship about this matter, and these brothers who went to GPP, and also brothers who have holidays and want to spend it in Los Angeles, we're going to also have a fellowship with you. Other ones are interested, and also parents, if you want to know more information, we're here. Amen? Hallelujah. This is the moment to serve the Lord. Go to the GPP. We have GPP in Barcelona. And also we have projects in other countries, many languages. And also a brother in Germany. You have the opportunity to work there in Germany for a year. So you have many opportunities to serve in Romania. We have a book affair there. There's a social work there. And then we also have two other opportunities. It has been said, and young people, they went to Dublin to go to GPP and also study English. For 8 months, there is a visa. You have 4 hours a day, you study English, and then you also serve at book affair. We have meetings in the morning, in the evening, and we also preach the gospel. So We contacted local people in Christ. So this is a great opportunity. And this time, we have two houses in Dublin, a girl's house and a boy's house. We also have an opportunity in London. We have a house in London. And because the pound has gone down, it's cheaper to study English in London. So now you can also study English and serve at Book Cafe and live the church life in London and Dublin. So also, we count on you. Take this opportunity. If you haven't gone to the GPP, this is an opportunity to serve there. So if you went to the GPP, it's a chance to be perfected and help us. And also, we have a project to go to university in Portugal. So Josman is from Porto, Portugal. He came to the Young People's Conference, and he's going to announce this to you. Amen. Saints, praise the Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus, I want to ask you three things. The first one is, who here goes to university, is going to enter university, is going to graduate. So who here has a desire to serve the Lord? Who thinks it's a rich experience to graduate or get a master's degree and serve the Lord at the same time? Lord Jesus, so this project, it recruits students for the spreading of the kingdom. So as Brother Ezra said, you are an army, and we need soldiers in the front battle, in the front line of the battle of the army. So this project is in the city of Porto. It's the second biggest city in Portugal, and it's very cheap to live there. It has a low cost of living. So we have many courses who are offered. So you don't need to take SATs or anything. And I can give you details. We have engineering. And here we have approximately the cost of living, the rent, transportation, light, and also university fee. So everything included is about 3,000 reais, and it's more accessible than private universities here in Brazil. And all these are for graduate students, but we also have opportunities for master's degree, PhD in Portugal. And I can give you more information later. Our intention here is that we may strengthen the church life in Europe to create local overcomers there, so you can study and serve the Lord there, always in the light of the Word, so may you may have a building up of the church there in Europe.
Também envia uma apresentação completa com todos os detalhes por e-mail, certo? Depois o irmão André vai mostrar onde é que a gente pode conversar sobre isso mais especificamente. Amém? Jesus é o Senhor.
Amen. Jesus is Lord.
Louvado seja o Senhor.
Praise be the Lord.
Querem anotar? Josmar Dantas P. Josmar. Vai lá. Josman Dantas P. @gmail.com. Desculpa,
Miguel. Gostaria que os irmãos passassem a apresentação do CEAP Joanesburgo. Irmãos, eu vou dizer uma coisa.
Well, Saints, I want to tell you something about the GPP in Joanesburgo. It was a miracle that we were able to build GPP. So there's a place for you. Is a GPP and a School of Kingdom Missions. So Bella Park is a place similar to Estancia. It has a big auditorium, small auditoriums, dorms, everything. So the owner of this place is a brother that has a great burden for the kingdom of heaven. And one day, I had a desire to take a few people there to have fellowship, a group of responsible brothers. So I asked to talk to him. He didn't know me, and he told me, oh, it's the brother Miguel from Brazil. And then he invited me to speak to the leaders of his group, and he didn't even know me. And I shared about the kingdom, and it had a great impact on them. You know, South Africa, we used to have apartheid, so we only had white people, so they have a kind of a prejudice toward other races. And then he thought, oh, who is this Chinese one? But then after I shared, everyone wanted to take a picture with me, because we had an impact on them. I didn't even know him. He invited me to share. He invited me to his office, and he said, Brother Miguel, this place is for the kingdom of God. This place is for the kingdom, you for the kingdom. And I say, I'm not the owner. God is the owner. I'm just the doorman. And I want to say that the keys of this place are yours. You can use this place for the kingdom of God. So this is how we got the partnership. So it's an environment to prayers. We have the prayer mountain, and it's famous in South Africa, Africa itself. This prayer of mountain, Christian leaders, important people, business people, they go there to pray. And African brothers, they are very, very dedicated to prayer. They go and pray for 1, 5, 10 hours. Some spend their night praying. So this is in Bella Park. And we also have book cafe in the mountain of prayer. So this place was given to us freely. The owner of Bella Park, he's coming. He came to Brazil. He told me, Brother Dong and Peter, he had a vision of book cafe, and he said, oh, book cafe is for the kingdom. If it's for the kingdom, there is a place there at Bella Park. So look, this is wonderful, saints, and I'm going to tell you what's happening today. Those leaders, those businessmen, Christian leaders, bishops, they go to Book of Fire to pray, and you know what's happening? The Spirit is talking to them. Oh, you need to go to Book of Fire. Because many of them, they are that desperate, seeking for the Lord's presence, and they say, oh Lord, there's no way. But the Spirit tells them, you need to go to Book of Fire. The way is going to be shown to you. And they go in, and we have the opportunity to speak about the kingdom and the vision that God gave us. And they are marveled. We're selling many books there, some by 5, 8, 10 books. So this GPP, for who is it, when, how much it's going to be? So what is this GPP? This GPP, School of Missions of the Kingdom, it lasts for 3 months, but even 2 or 1 month, according to the group. So we have 3 objectives. We have a spiritual experience with the Lord, to experience a new culture, and to learn English. So English is taught by a sister. He uses Bible to teach English. It's revolutionary. In 30 days, you're able to use the Bible and preach the gospel in English. If you want this experience, this opportunity, the prerequisite is for you to have 18 years old. And if you don't know English, it's okay. If you speak English, it's okay. This method is for everyone, every situation. So it's going to be in a school inside Bella Park. It's a new building, and we also cooperate with them. This is a place for Christians and leaders go to Africa. So the classrooms, they are very big. They have infrastructure. They have a lunchroom, dorms, convenience center.
Duração será de até 3 meses, levando em consideração a disponibilidade de cada aluno.
Nosso desejo. So it lasts for 3 months. We want to start in September.
E a disponibilidade a gente pode montar. Tá bem? Olha só então o currículo, a agenda.
We also have an agenda. We have a fellowship in the morning. We have English classes. We have classes at GPP. Social activities, you get to know the culture. So Brother Evilásio takes care of the spiritual side of this school. So all Christian groups that go there to have classes, we give the spiritual content. This is for the kingdom.
Hospedagem, tudo na escola, refeição completa, custo em torno de $750 por mês.
So it's about $750 a month, including English classroom, English classes, dorms, lunchroom. Of course, you need to pay for your own ticket.
Essa é uma realização. Eu vou dizer uma coisa. O que tem acontecido lá? Líderes cristãos, empresários, as pessoas têm ido.
So many Christian leaders, they go there, and God is making something, doing something unique there, because many Christian groups whose leaders are serious and have a vision of the kingdom and of the body. Do you know what they told me? Many leaders, they said, we only have one thing, but we need the part you have. And one of them told me, we all need to live the reality of the body of the Christ, of Christ. So we need to make everyone who is in the body to work. So dear beloved, the opportunity is here. You have this chance to serve in Africa. You have this chance, the opportunity to battle for the kingdom in this continent. Jesus is Lord.
Amen.